Welcome to the first part of a three-part series on painting the orc Morkanaut. Now in this first video I'm going to be showing you how to paint the hull of the miniature. Then in part two we'll be painting all the metallics and all the details on it. And finally in part three we'll be doing all the finishing touches. Now I'm going to be painting this model in the colour scheme of the Bad Moons clan, which is yellow. And yellow does have a reputation for being quite tricky to do, but while this isn't true, it's actually pretty easy. And in this video I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. So go and grab yourself a really big brush and let's get started. Now the first thing I want to point out to you is that I built the model with various sub-assemblies. So I've got the main part of the body just here, but also I built the entirety of the head separately, also the shooters, and I've got the crewman, and also the complete claw assembly as well. Now keeping these parts separate means that this painting is going to be much easier to do. And the first colour I'm going to be using is, well, the main colour of the model, which in this case is going to be yellow. So my base colour for yellow is Avalanche Sunset. And now, as always, give the paint a good shake. And the brush I'm going to be using is a large dry brush, and that's because it's got lots of bristles. It's a really large brush, which is ideal for a large area like this. So first thing to do is just load up your brush with some paint and put it on a palette like this. Now using the palette means I can control exactly how much paint is on my brush, so I can prevent putting on too much at once and clogging up detail. So once you've got some paint on your brush, just grab your model, pick a start point, and just start painting it yellow. Now there is obviously a lot of area to cover, and as you can see when I paint this on, you can still see some of the black through it. Now that's absolutely fine. All you got to do is wait for it to dry and then apply another layer afterwards. It's always best to apply multiple thin layers than one thick layer, because one thick layer can dry lumpy and start clogging detail, whereas multiple thin layers, you can always stay in control of that. Now if you find that you need to water down your paint at all, then I recommend you use a large brush to do that on your palette, because this brush, it absorbs water very quickly, so it can be very hard to control exactly how much you're thinning the paint down by. But then just switch back to this one for doing the actual painting. But for now, you just need to paint all of your yellow, and you don't need to be particularly neat about it, because we're going to be neatening up later on anyway with other base colours. So I've finished applying the yellow base coat, and it took two thin layers to get to this stage, but you see now I've got a nice, bright, strong colour. Now what I'm going to do now, before I move any further on painting the yellow, is start painting on some Abaddon black. And this is just to mark out which panels I want to be black, and then leave which panels I want to be yellow. This way I avoid doing any unnecessary highlights or shades later on, you see, so it just saves time, really. Now I've got both a large brush and a standard brush for doing this, and it's just a case of popping your paint on the palette. And then I like to thin it down with a small amount of water, like this. And this helps the paint flow smoothly from the brush onto the model. So just load up your brush with some, and it's just a case of looking on your model and picking some panels that you want to be black. So this shoulder, for example, I'm just going to neaten it up by painting this colour on like this. Now if you need any ideas or guidance as to which bits to paint a different colour, then just have a good look at the box art and also check out the website, and that will give you some ideas. So now I've decided which panels are going to be black, I can carry on painting the yellow. And the next step for the yellow is to shade it. And for this, you're going to need Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to be using a detail brush because the technique's going to be quite fine here. I'm not going to just going to be shading whole panels. Instead, I'm going to be focusing it. So pop some of the shade onto your palette, and make sure you don't have too much on your brush. You don't need lots and lots. And what you have to do is start working around all these yellow areas that you've painted, just letting this shade run into recesses between panels like that. So you see I'm neatly painting it in between areas like that. And doing this just helps really define that detail and helps the shape pop out. Now there are quite a lot of areas to do like this. I mean, there's lots of areas where panels join, like along here, for example. And also, there's lots of rivets, and you'll need to paint each one of those too. So just let the shade run around each one like that. There are also lots of scratches on the model, and they're all over the front especially. So just run a little bit of shade in amongst them like that. So doing this will take a little while, but the results are going to be absolutely worth it. Now I've finished the shading, you can see it's made a really big difference to the model. All those shapes and features are really jumping out. So the next step is to highlight them. And I'm going to be using Hexos Pale Sun for this, which is a dry paint. And I'm going to be using the large dry brush that I did the original stage with when we first base coated it yellow. Now I've made sure the brush is completely dry before starting this step, because if the brush is still wet, it can leave a bit of a streaky mess on the model. So when it's completely dry, get some on the end of your brush like that, and then get some tissue and just start working the paint into it like this. Now this will get the paint in amongst the bristles and also get rid of any excess paint, because you don't really need very much on your brush. In fact, having your brush looking like that is perfect. So what you do is grab your model and then look for all these sharp features and just lightly start flicking the brush across them like that. Now doing this, you can see that brighter yellow is starting to catch on all the edges of these details and really starting to bring those features out. So it's just a case now of working around all the yellow parts. So I've got all the body here and I've also got the claw. Now apply this in moderation because it's easy to add more as you go along if you're not happy with the amount you've got on. But just take your time and then we'll move on. Now that I've finished the dry brushing, you can see it's given some really nice highlights on all the edges of those panels. And there's just one more thing that I want to do in the yellow before we move on, and that's to apply a glaze to it. And doing this is really going to enrich that yellow and make it much brighter. So the colour is Lamenta's yellow, and I'm going to be applying it using my large brush. And, glazes look a lot like shades, but they're a bit different. So once you've got some on your palette and loaded on your brush, you need to apply it in a slightly different way. So what I do is pick a panel, so I'm going to start with this one here. And when you paint this on, right, with a shade, you'd let it settle and build up in the recesses. But with a glaze, you want to keep it moving so that you keep it smooth across the whole area. So what I like to do is paint an entire panel one at a time. And this way I avoid it drying and, well, if I try and pick it up again after it's dried, you can get some marks showing where you finished. So just keep going until you do a whole panel and pick another one and do all of that. And you can see that yellow there is much brighter around there now. So it's just a case now of working around all these panels and making them brighter. Now that the glaze has dried, you can see it's really brightened up that yellow and made it nice and strong and vibrant. So now we're going to move on to painting the black panels, and there's something really cool I want to show you on these. It's a good trick that, sometimes heavy metal do this. What you do is get some Rhinox Hide and some Lamia Medium, and you just need to mix them together on your palette. Now I'm using a detail brush for this, and, well, it's a bit of advice. Whenever you're using Lamia Medium, make sure you clean your brush before you pick up any of it, so that you avoid contaminating the medium with any pigment. So what you do is mix them together, so you're making a really strong kind of a shade colour here, like this. Make sure you don't have too much on your brush, because the application for this is the same as when we were shading the yellow earlier on. So what you do is find some black panels, and just start painting this mixture into the recesses between the panels like this. So it's a subtle effect which adds character and adds some warmth to these black panels. Now I've finished painting with the Rhinox Hide, you can see it's very subtle, but it's made the black just a bit more interesting. The next stage is to move on to highlighting it. For this, we're going to be dry brushing it like we did with yellow, but you need to be much more careful with this step, because the colour I'm using is Longbeard Grey, and this colour is very strong, okay? I'm using a medium dry brush for this, and it's just a case of, like before, working the paint into your bristles like this, and make sure that you have very little paint left on the brush before you move on to painting onto the model. In fact, having your brush looking like that is ideal. So I'll do the head for this because the whole head's black. And what we're going to be doing is looking for all the sharpest edges, so around the jaw, for example, and focusing the dry brushing on those parts only, like that. You see how it's starting to bring out that line? So what you're going to do is work around all these black components doing this, being careful with the dry brushing. So this includes the body and the claw as well. If you get any parts on the yellow, that's not a problem though, you just need to neaten up afterwards with some Avalan Sunset. Now I've finished doing the dry brushing on the black, and you can see it's brought out the detail really nicely. So now that this colour is finished, we can move on to the next area, which is going to be painting white onto the teeth and also onto the glyphs around the body and on the head. Now for this we're going to need four colours. We're going to be starting out with Celestra Grey, then we're going to be shading it with Agrax Earthshade. After that, we will layer it with Ulthuan Grey, then finally we're going to put on some highlights with some White Scar. Now, I'm going to be using a standard brush to start out with this, and what you do, this is Celestra Grey. Just get some on your palette and thin it down with a little bit of water. And it's important for these stages that you make sure you don't have too much paint on your brush. That way you can control what you're doing easily, you see. So what I like to do is just drag my brush along and twist it like that. That brings the bristles to a nice point and also gets rid of any excess paint that we don't need. All you need to do is look around the parts for the areas that are going to be white. So these larger teeth at the front, for example, just a case of base coating this colour on like this, so you get a good strong colour. Remember that doing multiple layers is better than one thick layer, so if you can still see some of the undercoat through, just apply another layer later on. So we've got areas like these larger teeth here, there's also these two on this side, and then there's also some smaller teeth on the inside there. And for the glyphs, I'm going to be painting the raised symbol in the middle of the square, so like this part just here. and then apply some Agrax Earthshade to all the rivets and scratches and the teeth. You don't need to do this to the glyphs, though, because there aren't really any details like this on those. Once the shade's dry, use a detail brush to apply some Ulthuan Grey as a smooth layer over the top of these areas that you want to be white. Now, as you're doing this, just make sure that you leave the darker colour showing in the recessed areas, like these scratches around here. And also, don't forget to do the glyphs. And then the final part is to use just a bit of white scar and a detail brush to paint some thin highlights on these areas of detail. So this is generally thin white lines like this, going around all the recesses and edges, like on those two scratches there. This also means going around the edges of all these parts and the glyphs too, and as well, just putting a bit of white on top of the rivets, like that. So there we go, the white is now complete, and now I can move on to the final part of painting all the armour plating on this model, which is to apply a chipping effect to it. Now to do this, you're going to need two colours. You need Rhinox Hide and Lead Belcher, and you also need to find yourself a bit of sponge. Now the piece I've got here is a spare part from a figure case, and what you do is just ball it up so you've got some sticking out your fingers like that. And get your paint, so it's Rhinox Hide first of all, just dab it in there so you get a bit loaded on the sponge, then start dabbing it into your palette like this. Now, the key to doing this technique right is to apply it in moderation. So using the palette like this, you can gauge exactly how much you've got on the sponge. So I've got about the right kind of amount there. And what you do is just grab a hold of your model and start lightly sponging this onto the armour. And you can see you get a really random chipping effect. There you are. That's really cool, isn't it? So what you've got to do is just work around your model doing this. But as you can probably tell, this is really messy. So if I do it now, it means that I won't have to repaint any details later on. So that lens, for example, if I painted that first, you see, I'd be making a big mess on it. So it's just a case of adding as much of this now as you like. Once you've finished the Rhinox Hide, repeat the process with Lead Belcher this time. Now focus the silver on all the areas that you've already done with the brown, and you can see there, it's showing the metal shining through as all the paint's chipped away. Now if you're going to be doing this using the same sponge, make sure you've completely cleaned it first, and made sure it's thoroughly dry as well. And also notice on this vehicle, I'm tending to focus the silver towards the bottom of the vehicle where more of the paint will have chipped away, especially around the feet where they're going to be moving and banging against the hull. So there we go. Now I've just dry fitted on the head and the arm. They're not glued, but I just wanted you to see what the whole thing is going to be looking like as we complete it. And now we've got a really nice bright yellow, and also it's all chipped and damaged, just like an orc vehicle should be. So when you're painting this stage of the model, remember with the yellow, you will need to do multiple thin coats of it to get a nice bright colour. And this is better than doing one thick colour, because that way you keep all the detail nice and crisp. And when you're doing the glaze on the yellow, make sure you do a complete armour panel at a time. That way you avoid any marks where part of it's dried and you have to go back and pick it up again. And when you move on to doing the chipping, make sure that the sponge is completely dry and clean before you move on to doing the silver parts of it. And remember as well, the chipping is the final part of doing this stage, but we're doing it now so that we avoid getting it on any of the detail which we're painting later on. So this video is now complete, and we're going to move on to part two, where we'll be doing all the metal and the detail. So I'll see you there.